few sections are left out. So to recapitulate, I will just give what we had discussed yesterday, after the charge sheet is filed under section 173, copy being furnished to the accused under 207, charges come to be played. Charges are normally played from the material on record before the court from the charge sheet and the documents referred therein and not any other document. 211 frame charges. So the contents of charge mean an accusation with the accused is required to meet before the court of law. So 211 speaks of contents must be given of a charge. Full particulars must be given of a charge. Sections must be mentioned in the charges as to the accused is sought to be prosecuted for what purposes, isn't it? Charges. Now, one more section, it said that a 211 subclause 6, the charges shall be written in the language of the court. Please note this mind. you will meet the expression language of the court is defined in section 272 CRPC. The state government may determine what shall be the purpose of the language. So in the state of Maharashtra, the language is Marathi as well as English is the court language. So CRPC being a subject which is coming in the concurrent list, each state has the right to legislate along with the central government. So in each state, the language will be different. In UP and Bihar, they will have a Hindi language. Tamil Nadu, they will have a Tamil language of the court. In Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh, Telugu and Kannada can be the language, along with the English language, because the Supreme, when the matter travels to Supreme Court and High Court, you require all documents to be interpreted and translated in English. So the language of the court is used in section 272. So section 211 subclause 6 says that here, the charge shall be written in the language of the court. So the judicial magistrate in Maharashtra, they can write charges in either Marathi or in English. So there is no bar. Even judgments can be written in Marathi. Only material part is required to be translated into English. So 211 ka requirement wo hai. Then illustrations are very interesting to section 211, where examples with regard to murder 299, 300 are given. Where accused must be communicated, whether the culpable homicide amounting to murder, not amounting to murder, whether the charge is falling within any of the exception, like a sudden and grave provocation, or the offense is committed as an act of self-defense, or an offense is a child within the meaning of section 84, that must be specifically mentioned. That is what the charge is said. Illustration B tells you that in the cases of voluntary causing hurt, it is the section must be specifically mentioned, 326 and equivalent to the statement, and also 335. 326 and 335 more or less they run parallel together, and 335 is a aggravated form where the charge must be specifically mentioned with sanction. Then in the cases of cheating, we have mentioned that here, cheating, theft, extortion, adultery, criminal intimidation, which must be specifically mentioned. That is what they mention at the same time. At the same time, it is the judicial discretion. The accused may tell the magistrate in case where the charge is separately being tried to request for that it may be clubbed together. Then 212 mandate that particulars of time and place must be mentioned. Full particulars must be mentioned. If particulars are not mentioned, the charge is vague. There can be a curable irregularity. That is why you have another section which says that the charges can be amended, isn't it? Like issues can be amended, charges can also be altered, alteration of a charge. So merely because the judge has made a mistake in framing a charge before leading evidence, either prosecution or defense can point out here. Then subclause 2 tells you that of section 211, in cases of breach of trust and dishonesty, misappropriation, it is sufficient to give the amount. Suppose what is misappropriated, the breach of trust is committed in respect of 1 lakh. If I gave you 1 lakh, maybe 1,000 rupees note, some of the 500 rupees note, some 50 rupees note. So there is no requirement that the magistrate must mention specifically 500 rupees ke note itne the, 100 rupees ke itne the, 100 rupees ke the. So there is no requirement. So there is no need to give specification in such matters. That is what subsection 2 of 212 tells you. Then 213 tells you manner of committing the offence must be in what manner certain offences must be specifically mentioned. What is the manner of committing the offences? Namely, for example, the accused has cheated the accused person. That is illustration B tells you. Then the charge must just set out the manner in which. Mean, for example, cheating has taken. If A has fraudulently induced B in buying the property on a representation that I am the owner of the property. Samjha na? Wo representation kab diya tha, on which date? When, whether he was the owner or not. Subsequently, he obtains a probate from the high court or a district court. Then he becomes the owner. He backs out. He takes a somersault. Now, at the time when I gave you the representation, I was not the owner. So the complainant got cheated, na? Acting upon the representation on day. For example, 1st of January 2000, he gave me the representation, he is the owner. He showed me the papers, he showed me the will that his grandfather has made a will. He is a ailing man, that he will become the owner. I believed in good faith that he is going to be the owner, or the owner entitled to property rights. I paid him the consideration in the hope that he will transfer the property. After 6 months, his father, grandfather dies. And he obtains a probate, and after obtaining probate, the value of the property is gone. He tells, I do not want to sell you because I was not the owner at the time. Your agreement with you and me is a void. So this is a fraudulent misrepresentation and you got cheated, must be given. But particulars need not be given in cases where the theft take place. Chori ho gaya. The accused has committed theft from dwelling place. Your servant has lifted from your house, for example, a gold ring belonging to your wife or a daughter or yourself. There is no reason to give particulars of the ring. Ye tha description, ye wahan se liya tha, yahan se liya tha. You can merely say that here the gold ring was given, kept it here, and the accused was employed as a servant and he has committed the offense of theft. And there is no need to set out the manner in which. Whether he came in a surreptitious manner, whether he committed the offense as a lurking house trespass is not necessary to mention. Because he is the person who is working for you in the house and the theft was committed. So there is no need to give it. Is my visibility is okay or not? I feel that, now it's okay. So, 213 ke requirement mein illustration dekh lijiye aap, only in the case of theft and a murder, that is item number E, the particulars, the charge need not be, manner may not be described. But other offenses such as the cheating ka take place and giving of a false evidence, that is a perjury in the court of law. Suppose you may take up the plea that the accused person has given a false evidence in the court of law that I have fabricated the forged signature of the deceased purchase and purchased the property, and which turned out to be false. So, because the evidence may be running into 300 pages, but you must point out the which paragraph. They say you must accuse in his deposition. Either maybe in the examination chief in cross-examination, at relevant paragraph number 22, he has made a false and given false evidence solely with a view to convict me that the sale deed has been forged by me and which I have examined the registrar and proved the signature which turned out to be so. So the evidence given by him is totally is a false in the eyes of law, he has committed the offence of perjury within the meaning of section 293, 294 of the Indian Penal Code. So the particulars must be furnished here under 213 subclause 3. And even in the case of that is what a C and D requires here. In the case of obstruction of B in discharge of public function, given time, the charge must set out A and B, the charge of his function. A is accused of obstructing B, a public servant, in discharging public function. Suppose a police officer is giving a signal asking you to go right and draw stop. आपने स्टॉप करने की जगह मालूम गाड़ी स्पीड कर चले गए, देन अनदर पुलिस ऑफिसर कॉट यू देयर एंड यू मैन हैंडल हिम, यू आर ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग हिम एंड असॉल्टिंग हिम. सो इन सच ए सिनेरियो द पर्टिकुलर्स मस्ट बी गिवन एंड इन द मैनर हाउ यू ब्रोक द सिग्नल, हाउ कैन द कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी टू प्लेस एंड हाउ यू अटैक यू, दैट चार्ज मस्ट स्पेसिफाई द पर्टिकुलर, दैट इज व्हाट. देन 2114 स्पीक्स ऑफ the charge in the sense offense is punishable. The exact wording must be mentioned. The language of the section must be given. Because 211 also speak to you that if a particular section or law gives a particular description, it says that the accused is a terrorist. That description terrorist must be given. Or is the accused is a habitual offender. That must be specifically must mention. Then 215 speaks of when there are effect of errors. When there are errors of two types, that is error which is omission which is committed by the judge or a magistrate in framing a charge without giving particulars. If the accused was not misled and he has led evidence despite being not, suppose despite full description is not given. For example, one particular section says that the accused has dishonestly misappropriated, acted in a dishonest manner. So the expression dishonestly is not mentioned by the magistrate or a session judge while framing a charge is not supposed to be fatal if the accused has understood and led evidence. That is why that can be cured unless there is a failure of justice. If there is a failure of justice, if the accused has not understood it, the charge is required to be modified or the charge has to be dropped. So illustration A to 215 tells you where the expression in section 242, which is dealing with the counterfeit coins, the expression fraudulently is there in the section if not mentioned, and that error in that regard, omission, shall not be regarded as material. It is not affecting the trial. It is a curable irregularity, and which can be cured ultimately by altering a charge under section 216. Then illustration B to 215 says that here, in the cases relating to cheating, the particulars are not given. Omission set out is not material. Because in cases of cheating, section 213 tells you, 213, illustration B kehta hai, in cases of cheating, the charge must set out the manner in which cheating take place. Now, if the magistrate or a session judge has failed to record such a finding and give reasons and a manner of cheating, how the representation was made, how you got deceived, and on which date you got deceived, and how you acted upon it, that is not mentioned. The charge is vague. So, section 215 illustration B says that a charge which is vague is set out so and so, the omission is set out is not a material one. But illustration C that here, a charge which cheating in the manner which cheating is not set out, and transaction is A and B, and A had no means of knowing. If there are several transactions, for example, A had loan amount of rupees 1 lakh. A also had a mortgage, his property taken loan. A had also pawned his jewelry, taken money. So when there are three transactions, the particulars must be mentioned. When the particulars are not mentioned, here the case is of material error. That should be rectified. That should be rectified by alteration. If alteration not done, then ultimately the charge is required to be withdrawn. You will not be permitted to lead evidence, then I will tell you how you withdraw the charge. How charge is withdrawn under section 224. Then clause D speaks of a case, of course, in cases of murder. In cases of murder, we learned that here the particulars need not be given. 213 illustration C, that here the charge need not state the manner in which A murdered B. So, taking into consideration illustration D to section 215, how the murder took place, whether it is a misdescription of Haider Baksh or a Khuda Baksh, that irregularity can be cured. It is not material. But whereas, as regard the illustration in E, here the error is material in the mention that here the dates of death are different here. The murder of Haider Baksh take place on 20th January, and whereas in the charge it is mentioned 21st January. So there is a difference. You cannot have contradictory dates in the matter here, as it is, unless the charge is corrected, you will not be permitted to lead evidence on that regard, and probably the charge may be withdrawn. Okay. Then 2-1 speak cases of alteration. I won't speak about it. How the permission can be granted by the court even before the judgment is pronounced. The charges can be altered in order to meet the ends of justice. Both the accused and the prosecution will be given opportunity to lead evidence, and they can point out a particular charge is wrongly framed and it should, there is no material, it should be dropped. The court may consider and give. So when alteration take place, then subsection section 2117 come into play, the on account of the de novo trial, because subsection 5 speaks of a fresh trial can be reordered by virtue of the alteration of a charge, addition of a charge, modification of charge. When a de novo trial means fresh trial, parties must be, the witnesses who were already examined earlier must be re-examined, because the earlier evidence was confined to only one charge, and second, third, fourth charge is framed. So evidence must be adduced. So the courts are not powerless under section 311 of the CRPC. The trial court has got power to recall witnesses, isn't it? Both the defense can be allowed to lead evidence and the prosecution can be allowed to lead evidence to place material before the court. Then 2118, we dealt with a case of in that there is a joinder of charges. There has to be, in the first instance, separate charges for each offense, and there should be a separate trial. Trial should be separately. But the proviso says, if the accused is charged for misappropriation, cheating, and a breach of trust, one person only, and also several offenses, he can make an application to the magistrate, my lord, instead of having separate trials and separate charges, and all the separate charges which have been framed can be clubbed, we can have one trial, with a view to avoid multiplicity of proceeding, so that I need not recall witnesses, and the witnesses, the common witnesses, I have a common advocate, I am the only witness, other witnesses also same, they are likely to depose, there will be hardship to everybody. So no prejudice is likely to cost to me if this honorable court is pleased to try all the charges together instead of separately as per the language of section 218. Now, notwithstanding what is stated in 218, the court has ample power. The legislature is granting power to the magistrate and the session judges to try certain offenses which have been committed within a span of 12 months. Maximum three number of offenses in one trial. Illustration given here is of a punishable theft 379, 388, theft in a dwelling house, and matters of similar kind. 319 can there, punishable with the same amount of punishment in IPC and also different act. If something is an offense in IPC and also an offense in other act, that can also be clubbed together. And if provided the offences are committed within a span of 12 months, they can be tried in one trial. There is no need to have a separate trial. That is what here the language. Then 220 gives a further discretion to the judge. A series of acts have been committed by the accused person. Namely, accused has committed murder. He has committed rape. He has committed robbery. Ye sab cheeze kiya hai usne. So all these charges will be framed and clubbed together, and one trial will be held as per the provisions of Section 220. Series of the offences here, isn't it? The same person is one person. One person committing, for example, he has kidnapped the girl. Aur kidnap karne ke baad uski jewelry nikal lega. Wo separate offence hai, isn't it? He has committed robbery. He has committed theft. And he rapes her. It's a serious offense of 376. Then he murders her. Then 300 mein aa gaya. Culpable homicide amounting to murder. So all these charges will be clubbed together and heard against him. It's a series of charges. That is what Section 220 speaks of. Then 222 speaks of how the one trial can take place in falsification of account. And in cases, other offences under 212, 212, and 219 and misappropriation of the property, that is takes place under Section 403 of the Act, one trial can take place. One trial will take place here. So there is no need to have a separate trial, the court. Then subclause 3 again speaks of a case where two or more separate definitions and law are given, and the court has the right to charge them together and have one trial at the same time. So these are all 219, 220, 221, 223. They give illustration. Yeah. The illustration contained in 220, that is illustration A to H. Of course, the A is involving a person being in lawful custody and doing the act grievous hurt to C, a constable. So a constable is performing duty, you are attacking him. That is a 225 grievous hurt. Aur attack karne ke saath mein usko dusre ko bhi maar diya aapne. The second constable tried to stop you, and you take out your revolver and punch him. 333 lag gaya. So that offense can be tried together by the court in the manner. Then illustration B ke hisab se here, how the adultery charge, adultery has been decriminalized, I told you. Adultery as well as the act of trespass is coming into play here, which can be tried separately. These are all under Section 218. Then illustration C also has the same impact as illustration B, that is with regard to trespass, adultery, and separately charged. Then D is in possession knowing of counterfeit coins. When a person is in counterfeit coins and an offence under Section 446 is committed along with other, then separate charge and it can be clubbed together. So A to B, C, D, all falling under Section 218, where a separate charge is required to be framed. But the law says that here, the separate charge may be framed, but they can be tried at the same time. So an application can be made by the accused, or the court may say that I can club together all the proceeding and one trial will be held in all the proceeding together. That is to avoid multiplicity of proceeding. Similarly, you may have filed a suit in the Bombay High Court, a civil suit, say for example, for a declaration that you are the owner of the property. And the accused person, the defendant is a trespasser. A defendant will take up the plea that here I have an irrevocable license, isn't it? Either he will file a counterclaim or he will file a separate suit, isn't it? When there are two separate suit here, depending on if the issues are involved, the court will frame two separate issues in both the matters. Separate issues, there will be a common trial. There can be a common trial in the same suit and adjudicate the matter. So similarly, see that the provisions of Section 219 after Clause G, it says that separate charges refer to A to H may be tried at the same time. So there is no bar in the magistrate or the court of session trying the matter. All issues may be 10 charges or various charges and in one trial. That is the meaning before this court. Then we also dealt with the doubt ke bare mein 221. The magistrate or a judge can frame charges here. When offense proved included offense charge, that is 222, also we dealt with. Now, today we have to deal with what persons may be charged jointly. So, when they cannot be charged jointly, we learnt it here. 218 ke andar, illustration ke andar. Now, when may be charged jointly? So, what are the situation? What are the illustration? The following number one, person accused of the same offense in the same course of transaction, they can be charged together. Suppose A has committed the murder and B has instigated the murder. And there is a common intention and C has conspired to do the act. So all three of them will be tried together. They will be joint trial. That is the illustration. Okay, then a person accused of the offense or a person accused of abetment of a charge committing. So abetment under section 114, where in such an event, a charge under section 34 will come into play. Both of them had the common intention. A common intention in furtherance of which the act of cheating has taken place. Isn't it? Then illustration C, check here. Person accused of more than one offense of the same kind within the meaning of 219. That is, within 1 year committed three offenses can be tried jointly together. Then E, a person accused of the offense which include theft, extortion, cheating, criminal breach of misappropriation of receiving stolen goods. So these are all common type of connected offenses, more or less akin to each other. So they can be, they all of them will be joined together. They may be one accused, two accused, three accused, five accused. Then F, may person accused of the offense under 411, stolen property, 414 Indian Penal Code, in respect of stolen property in possession referred to. So somebody steals a property. I steal your property and I sell it to C. He is the receiver of the stolen good. He will also be he will also be brought along with me. So I stole your watch and I sold it to the jewelry shop gentleman. He is the receiver of the stolen good. And he has no right to sell it to anybody, take money, without being convinced whether the man who is selling him had a title to it. Receipt ka manga usne. Chori karke bhej diya mobile phone kisi ka. So receiver, he will also be entitled here. G mein aa jaiye. A person accused of the offense under chapter 12 of the relating to counterfeit coin, accused of any other offense relating to coin, abetment, so and so. So a person in possession of the counterfeit coin and who gave it to him and where he exchanged it, all of them can be tried together and a common trial will take place. Provided where the number of the person charged with separate offenses do not fall any of the categories specified in the section, magistrate may such person, an application in writing desire, such person would not be prejudicial. So if there are, because the condition is that here only three charges can be brought together. If there are four and five more people are there, the magistrate may try the matter if they are not affected. That is the meaning here. So there is no bar. This irregularity is a curable irregularity, not one. Okay? This is all relating to charges, which is quite a liberal provision. Why it is liberal? Because the accused and the prosecution both will have a chance to make an application for alteration, for amendment of a charge. At any stage, even at the stage of a judgment, before judgment is delivered. That is why is a very liberal approach is adopted in framing charges, like a liberal approach is adopted in framing of the issues in the CPC here. So then I told you that here, when no evidence is led, when a charge is not complying with the requirement of the provisions of this chapter in CRPC, that is chapter 17, when a charge can be withdrawn with the permission of the court. Can the prosecution and the accused withdraw? Please see section 224, will come to you. When a charge containing more than one head is framed against the same person, that is, murder, rape, theft, robbery, kidnapping, all are charged here. And when a convicted has been on one of the more of them, the complainant or officer conducting the prosecution may, with the consent of the court, withdraw the remaining charges. So if he has been convicted on the offense of a murder, 302, the court may say, I am convicting him to life imprisonment or should be hanged up to death. The other charges need not be proved, because he is getting maximum punishment. So the complainant and the prosecution will tell the court here, the other charges become redundant, having given maximum punishment, and there is no point in examining other witnesses and other charges. So the charge of a culpable homicide amounting to murder under 300 is proved, and it's a heinous crime, and it's a rarest of rare crime, along with rape and 376, and your lordship has given maximum punishment. So during the course of that commission of the offense, he has committed minor offenses like theft, he has committed kidnapping, he has committed stolen the property. These are all properties he has sold it to various persons in the market. Those witnesses are not available, A, B, C. So having accorded maximum punishment, and there is no necessity to proceed further for it, for deposing or giving evidence or trying the other charges, which will be waste of time, that application can be made for withdrawal to the court, withdraw the remaining charges, or the court on its own accord may stay the inquiry. So if the court has, for example, court has power to hold inquiry. All of you know that, isn't it? Magistrates hold the inquiry under the CRPC. When inquiry, the trial may go on in respect of some cases, some charges, inquiry will be going on. As to how the abatement has taken place, the dead body, what is the cause of death, which is not clearly mentioned in the autopsy report, the court session judge may say that I would like to have an inquiry held here, though the accused is admitting. Now, you know that in one of the cases, in Stan Swamy's case, though the accused has dead and gone, the accused person, family members, they want his name cleared. They want his prosecution to go on, let the inquiry take place. So inquiry provisions, all of you know that section 176 kholenge aap, aapko milega, 176 kholiye dar aap, one of the provision regarding inquiry, I am just giving it to you. The inquiry by magistrate into cause of death. Please open section 176. When the case is of the nature referred to in clause I, so and so 3 of 174. 174 deals with the inquest panchanama, where the police is required to find out the cause of death, how the body was there, slit hoi thi kya, kaun si injury hai, kya mark hai. The police should have examined a doctor, medical expert, and chemical analysis expert, serologist, all the DNA specialists. Wo karne ke bawajood bhi medical evidence was late ho gaya. The police officers' investigations are defective. Then magistrate can hold inquiry. That is what, see, 176 is a very wide power. So yeah, inquiry, he can hold it here. The cause of death can there. This is one of the provision. One lecture will be totally for inquiry provision. I will deal with it here later on. There are a lot of provisions in the CRPC, section 176, 145, 146, 144, base up provisions. I will tell you here the way. So that is the meaning here. 224 mein kaha diya, when staying the inquiry, whatever inquiry which the magistrates must have held, must have instituted for finding out the cause of death, for finding out how the commotion took place or how the offense took place. So the magistrate has, the session judge or a magistrate has a right to withdraw or drop the remaining charges if the principal charge is proved. Samjhe na aap? Then see, in that event, they will pass an order in that charges, the either conviction set aside or he will be acquittal. So when no evidence is laid in respect of those charges, the accused stands acquitted. Accused has committed, while committing the offense of rape, he has removed her ornaments and sold it, and he has committed kidnapping, olekia, but he has admitted that, yes, I had forced the girl and I had a sex with her, then I killed her. So like in the case of Nirbhay's case, Mukesh Kumar and many of them went to Supreme Court. Ultimately, you have seen that here. In the bus, they commit the offense. Even her friend was done to death. So it was a grievous crime. When the several charges are framed, the incidental charges, which do not much hold water, when substantial punishment has been accorded, maximum punishment of death is given, the chote mote charges ke liye karne ki zarurat hi nahi. Unless both the parties agree, please note that, or in the opinion of the session judge or a magistrate, either of the opinion in that regard. So this will bring us to the closure of a chapter on framing of a charges. And anybody has any doubt, iske baad kya hone wala hai court mein? The judge has framed charges now. There was a FIR under 154. Investigations commenced from 156 onwards to 189 onwards. Investigation. Then charge sheet is filed under section 173. Then the police officer under 173 forwards the accused to the accused. Here there's the offence is committed. The magistrate take cognizant under section 190 clause. Anybody knows? Clause B. When in a police report, the case is done. That is 190 clause B. Please remember this. Bhulna mat here. See, upon a police report, cognizance is taken under 190. We are not dealing with a police case. So when a cognizance is taken, the magistrate or a session judge, relying upon the documents in the first in the charge sheet 173. If the case is triable by the court of session, he will commit the proceeding under 209. Or if they're triable by the magistrate, he will try himself. Then he will start framing charges. Charges are required to be framed. The charges contents are mentioned from section 211 to 24. So charge frame hone ke baad, what is the next stand? What is the next step? The next step is you will have to come to session trial before a magistrate. In warrant cases, trial before a magistrate. In cases instituted otherwise than in a police report, then a trial in summon cases, trial in summary cases, where the next step is recording of a plea. This I will deal with it. Recording of a plea, then commencement of the evidence. I will deal with it. Anybody want to ask me any question before I go? What is the time now, Kumar, at the moment now? Yeah, we still have time, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
It is 7:14.
We'll have a break at 7:20.
7:20. Okay. Now, anybody want to? This is a session for question answer. After sir. Question answer, I will take the next lecture. Bol dijiye, because a very important chapter. Please note that. So your concept should be clear to you that here the framing of a charge comes into play only after the FIR is accepted by the police, investigation has commenced, police report is filed. And 170 ke andar the police forwards the accused to the magistrate. Forwarding of the magistrate in custody. Now the Supreme Court yesterday under 170, the expression custody doesn't mean he should be arrested. There is no need to be arrested. Isn't it? There is no. Even if the accused is willing to come and cooperate and come to the court of law and police officer, why to arrest him? The Gujarat High Court and many high courts have taken the view that unless you arrest the accused person and bring him under 170, we will not take the charge sheet, which is a wrong proposition. I had given the judgment to you. I will discuss it with you after the end of this lecture. go through jab. So there is no requirement the accused must be arrested. Only if the accused is absconding, not likely, if in the opinion of the police officer, वो भागने वाला है, नहीं आने वाला है, cooperate नहीं करने वाला है, they will available warrant of arrest, a non-bailable warrant is issued. So under 170, the magistrate forwards the accused with a request to the police, with the magistrate to take cognizance under section 190, sub clause B, CRPC on a police report. Please note that the police officer has the right to withhold certain documents which are very important, which he may feel that which will secret document. This document will affect the state of the power. These are under section 123, 124. These are affairs of the government. These are official communication. Information disclose karna dangerous hai. Official secret act ke document nahi karenge. Parliament ke document release nahi karenge. That is what the language of section 170, you bear in mind. What documents are referred to? The magistrate, the police officer and the magistrate is bound to give to the accused all the documents. If the documents are very bulky and heavy record, he will tell him, please take inspection. All the documents, don't insist for it. Because ultimately, charges are framed based upon the document which are furnished to him under section 170 and 173. So 173 ko bhuliye mat jao, is very, very important section. Because without 170, 173 will not come. And without 170 and 173, cognizance under 190 clause B by the magistrate will not come into play. And without that material and document, charges cannot be framed. Charges essentially are framed only from the document which have been sent by the police officer under 170 and 173. Please, this is a very, very important section which is go step by step. Mind you that. कुछ पूछना है तो पूछ लीजिए मेरे को भी
आप। दशरथ सर,
हाँ पूछ लीजिए।
सर, I had a doubt under 218. Sir, if the charges are framed in contravention to 218, can they be cured under irregular proceedings?
Yes, there is alteration में कर सकते हैं ना आप?
नहीं, alteration में नहीं, शायद सर 460 से start होता है।
हाँ।
वो irregular proceedings में।
Irregular proceeding that last में section 460 onwards, isn't it?
हाँ सर, तो
या दैट इज इररेगुलरिटी, इट कैन नॉट बी क्योर्ड ना. द 460 व्हाट इज इररेगुलर प्रोसीडिंग्स इज मेंशन इन द सेक्शन 460, यस इजंट इट, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 35 के अंदर. इररेगुलरिटी व्हिच डू नॉट विशिएट प्रोसीडिंग्स.
यस सर, सो इफ अंडर 218 मतलब एक साथ अगर चार्जेस को क्लब कर दिया जो क्लब करना नहीं चाहिए था बेसिकली अंडर 218,
हां
तो मतलब वो इररेगुलर में जाएगा क्या?
But provided if the accused is totally prejudiced. Yeah?
Achha.
Accused must be deeply prejudiced. You read the word, section 218, dekho aap, 218, dobara check kar lo aap, uske andar expression use kiya hai, deeply prejudiced, proviso check karo aap, together any number of the, is not likely to be prejudiced thereby. Okay? Provided that where the accused upon application in writing, so, direct opinion that the accused is not likely to be prejudiced. So there should be no prejudice to the accused. Samjhe na aap? When he is likely to be prejudiced, then the charge can be dropped, can be withdrawn. So the
accused, or fir usko baad mein separately trial kiya jayega ya fir it will be dropped?
It can be drawn if the trial is going, if they go on. If the trial is not going on, they can be a separate charge. They will reframe a charge. There will be a de novo trial. Kya bolte hai? De novo trial, you please see the de novo trial ke liye provision 216 sub clause 5.
Sir, can you repeat the section?
Section 216 sub clause 5. If the offense stated altered or charge with one of the prosecution of it previous, sorry, no need. 214, ek minute, adjourn the matter, accused. You know what, dekho kidhar use kiya gaya word? Four me use kiya na? Yes. If the alteration is such, proceeding immediately with the recklessness and opinion, prejudice the accused person, prosecutor, the court may either direct the trial or adjourn the proceeding as the case may be. Either direct a new trial. See that word? 216 sub clause 4. Samjhe na aap?
Okay, so a de novo trial will be ordered. Direct
yeah, new trial is a de novo trial. Starting a case again, repeat the entire matter. Ultimately, framing of a charge is like a framing of issues in the Code of Civil Procedure. Merely non-framing of a particular issue, but is the material and record you are given evidence. But if the accused has given some description and he has given evidence explaining the charge despite not framing it, he can be either convicted or he can be let off by the court. If there is a material, if the explanation is satisfactory, the court will say that I will acquit him. If the explanation is not satisfactory, the court will say he has cooked up the evidence and I will convict him.
Okay.
Or if the court is in doubt and evidence is not there, there should be a new trial. Let there be a charge be again reframed, because the accused will be affected. In case I proceed to go ahead with the matter, there should not be injustice to the accused. Ultimately, the right of the accused is akin to life and liberty under Article 21 of the Constitution. Sanjana, the trial must be fair. It must not be unfair to the accused person. Okay?
Sir, also under 224, the language of the section clearly says ki such withdrawal, if given, shall have the effect of an acquittal of such charge. तो सर अगर यू गेव एन एग्जांपल ऑफ वेरी हीनियस क्राइम्स मतलब रेप या फिर मर्डर को एक साथ क्लब किया होगा तो इफ ही इज कन्विक्टेड फॉर इम्प्रिजनमेंट फॉर लाइफ और डेथ तो अदर्स विल बी विड्रॉड बट अगर से आईपीसी 260 या 264 जैसे व्हाट यू हैव इज मतलब गवर्नमेंट स्टैम्प्स को काउंटरफिट किया है या कुछ कॉइंस को काउंटरफिट किया है इफ देयर इज एन इम्प्रिजनमेंट फॉर 7 इयर्स And the other crimes has an imprisonment for 3 years or 1 year. Will that be also matlab acquittal ho jayega kya usme?
If he is convicted for longer, if he has convicted for a major offense, if the major offense evidence is more or less correlated to the minor offense, both the parties may agree that here there is no need to try it. He is even awarded 7 years maximum term.
या फिर मतलब सर द आफ्टर द इम्प्रिजनमेंट इज कंप्लीटेड उसके बाद ही कैन बी चार्ज्ड अगेन है सर
नो नो ही कैन नॉट बी बिकॉज़ देयर विल बी अ डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ सेक्शन ये लगेगा ना सेक्शन 300 लगेगा दैट इज डबल जियोपॉडी लगेगा डबल जियोपॉडी लगेगा उसके अंदर वंस इट इज वन द कोर्ट हैज नॉट गिवन अ फाइंडिंग द कोर्ट हैज टू गिव अ फाइंडिंग ही स्टैंड्स एक्विटेड एक्विटल ऑर्डर इज रिकॉर्डेड डिस्पाइट रिकॉर्डिंग एविडेंस यू कैन नॉट रीचार्ज हिम अगेन ऐसा नहीं कि मुझे भूल हो गई आई कुड नॉट डू हिम द मजिस्ट्रेट एंड अ जज हैज टू कॉन्शियसली अप्लाई देयर माइंड इट इज ओनली बाय एप्लीकेशन ऑफ माइंड दे कैन टेक डिसीजन 224 का मतलब 224 इज नॉट टू बी एक्सरसाइज इन ए ऑर्डिनरी मैनर विद ग्रेट सर्कमस्पेक्शन एंड कॉशन रीडिंग द एंटायर मटीरियल एंड रिकॉर्ड एंड द लाइक्लीहुड ऑफ द कन्विक्शन इन द चार्जेस बोथ द पार्टीज एग्रीइंग कोर्ट ओपिनियन बट इफ द कोर्ट फाइंड्स दैट हियर Evidence is in both the proceedings of similar nature. Ultimately, if he is convicted in both the proceedings, ultimately what? As a defense lawyer, kya bolenge aap? The sentence may run concurrently. Kya bolenge?
Yeah, sentence may run concurrently.
Section 31 CRPC, read with section 70 of the Indian Penal Code. So, may not be, usme 7 saal diya, isme 3 saal diya, 10 saal ho jayega. My lord may make it concurrently, mean ultimately 7 years ही होगा. वो तीनों साथ में मिल जाए, दोनों मिल जाएंगे. So there is ultimately there is a remedy, either this way or that way. So what could not be attained directly can be attained indirectly. समझे ना आप?
Yes.
So section 31 clearly says that here, nothing to worry, ultimately remedy है. और कुछ पूछना है किसी को भैया? So we will come after 10 minutes after a cup of tea. Unless anybody has any more question. Yes, Kumar? Ashutosh?
Sir, I think we can take a break.
Okay, chalo, all the best. 224, yes. See you.